Good afternoon, dear children. Let us continue the lesson, transport of substances in plants and animals. Okay, and last class we have discussed about the structure and working of heart, and also we have learned the composition of blood. Okay, all of you learned that portion. Okay, and today's class we are going to discuss about the lymphatic system of human body. Okay, lymphatic system of human body. Actually, the lymphatic system that contains, it is a subsystem of circulatory system. Okay, actually the lymphatic system is the subsystem of circulatory system. Okay, circulatory system that we already learned, isn't it? And here, the lymphatic system actually that contains lymph vessels and lymph nodes. Okay, lymphatic system consists of lymph vessels and lymph nodes. Listen it. Lymphatic system consists of lymph vessels and lymph nodes. Actually, the lymph vessels are thin-walled vessels. Okay, like blood vessels or thin-walled tube-like structures like blood vessels. Okay, lymph vessels are thin-walled tube-like structures like blood vessels, and actually the lymph vessels that carries lymph. Okay, lymph vessels actually carries lymph. Actually, the lymph is the fluid that flows through the lymphatic system. Okay, lymph is the fluid that flows through the lymphatic system. Listen it. And here the lymph nodes, actually the lymph nodes are small structures that work as filters. Okay, actually the lymph nodes are small structures that work as water, that work as filters for harmful substances. Okay, these are small structures actually that work as filters for harmful substances. Okay, also the lymph nodes contains immune cells. Okay, the lymph nodes contains immune cells. Okay, the lymph nodes contains actually immune cells, and these cells can attack and destroy the germs. Okay, that is disease causing germs. Okay, since the lymph nodes contains immune cells that can attack and destroy the germs that cause diseases. Okay, and actually that is about the lymph vessels and the lymph nodes. And the lymph nodes are spread through the entire body. Okay, and most of the lymph nodes are located near to neck and head. Okay, most of the lymph nodes are located near head and neck. Okay, here the lymphatic system is the subsystem of human circulatory system. And here the lymphatic system that consists of lymph vessels and lymph nodes. Okay, lymph vessels and lymph nodes. And lymph vessels are actually thin-walled tubes that looks like actually blood vessels. And these lymph vessels that contain lymph. Okay, actually lymph is a fluid that flows through the lymphatic system. Okay, and next the lymph nodes, actually they are structures, they are small structures that work as filters for harmful substances. Okay, and also the lymph nodes contain immune cells, and these cells can attack and destroy the germs that cause diseases. Okay, and actually there are above hundreds of lymph nodes are situated throughout our body, and most of the lymph nodes are situated near to head and neck. Okay, that is about the lymph vessels and lymph nodes. Next we can see how does the lymphatic system works. Okay, how does the lymphatic system works? As you know, the blood that flows through the capillaries. Okay, the blood that flows through the capillaries. That time, some of the plasma, you know, what is plasma actually? You already learned. Actually, it is the fluid portion of blood that is called the plasma. Okay, the fluid portion of blood that is called actually plasma. Okay, Here, as the blood that flows through the capillaries, some of the plasma that oozes out, okay, that means some of the plasma that comes out of the walls, okay. The blood that flows through the capillaries, some of the plasma come out of the walls, okay. And next, the most of the fluid that engages the limb vessels, okay. Most of the fluid that engages the limb vessels. Also, it is drained back into the blood vessels. Okay, from the limb vessels, it drains back to the blood vessels. Listen it. As the blood that flows through the capillaries, some of the plasma come out of the walls. Okay, and most of the fluid that engages the limb vessels, from there, it drains back to the blood vessels. Okay, before the fluid that enters the or that returns to the circulatory system, it is filtered in the lymph nodes. Okay, we already learned the lymph nodes that act as a filter. Okay, here before the fluid that returns to the circulatory system, it is filtered in the lymph nodes. Okay, it act as a filter, you know. The lymph nodes that contain special type of cells, that is actually called the immune cells. Okay, the lymph nodes that contain special type of cells called the immune cells. Actually, these cells protect our body from disease-causing organisms and harmful substances. Okay, the lymph nodes that contains special type of cells, they are called the immune cells that protect the human body from disease-causing organisms and also harmful substances. Okay, that is in this way actually the lymphatic system works. Listen it. Here, as the blood that flows through the capillaries, some of the plasma that come out of the walls. Okay, and most of the fluid that enters the lymph vessels, from there it drains back to the blood vessels. Okay, and before the fluid that returns to the circulatory system, it gets filtered in the lymph nodes. Okay, and here the lymph nodes that contains a special type of cells, they are called the immune cells. Okay, actually these cells protect the human body from disease-causing organisms and also from harmful substances. Okay, that is about the working of lymphatic system. Next, we can study the excretory system in human, that is human excretory system. Listen it, human excretory system. Okay, you know, carbon dioxide, that is one of the waste products formed and actually it is mixed into the blood. Okay, that thing, how the carbon dioxide is removed, that thing already we learned. Okay, and besides carbon dioxide, actually the human body produces several other kinds of waste materials. Okay, apart from carbon dioxide, human body produces several other kinds of waste materials which mix into the blood. Okay, apart from carbon dioxide, human body produces several other kinds of waste materials which mix into the blood. And here, one of the process, that is excretion, is the process through which these waste products from the body are removed. Okay, that is what is mean by excretion. Excretion is the process through which the waste products from the blood are removed from the body. Okay, what is excretion? Excretion is the process by which the waste products from the blood are removed from the body. Okay, excretion is the process. Excretion is the process through which the waste products from the blood are removed from the body. Listen it. Here, the human respiratory system, actually it is made up of the kidneys, then urinaries, urinary bladder and urethra. Okay, these are the important important parts in the human excretory system. human excretory system. The human excretory system actually consists of kidney, then ureter, urinary bladder and urethra. Okay, what are the different organs or parts in the human respiratory system? Actually, they are kidneys, then ureter, and this is urinary bladder and urethra. Okay, these are the important parts of human excretory system. Kidneys, then ureter, then urinary bladder and urethra. Okay, you know, human being has actually two kidneys. Okay, human being has two kidneys. Actually, they are located in the abdominal cavity. The kidneys are located in the abdominal cavity. Listen to it. The human being has two kidneys and they are located in the abdominal cavity. Okay, and here the each kidney that contains thousands of tiny tubules. Okay, that is tube-like structures, and they are actually what cause filters. Okay, each kidney contains several thousands of tiny tube-like structures, and they work as filters. Okay, each kidney contains thousands of tube-like structures, and they work as filters. Okay, and you know, through arteries, the blood that carry through the carried into the kidneys. Okay, the blood is brought to the kidneys through arteries. Through arteries, the blood is carried to the kidneys. Okay, actually, as the blood that flows through the kidney, okay, as the blood that flows through the kidneys, through the tiny tubules that filter the blood and separate waste from it. Okay, as the blood that flows through the kidneys, you know, the kidney contains tube-like structures. They act as filters. So, when the blood that flows through the kidneys, what happens? The tiny tubules that filter the blood and separate waste from it. Okay, the filter-like structures, that is filter-like tubules that separate the waste materials from the blood as it passes, flows through the kidneys. Okay, and the end product of this process, that is actually the waste product formed, is actually the urine. The waste product formed is actually the urine. Okay, then water, actually the urine contains water and waste materials filtered out from the blood. Okay, that is the waste materials that filtered out from the blood that contains water, the water mostly contain water. Okay, here the blood that is brought to the kidneys through arteries. The blood that is brought to the kidneys through arteries. Okay, and as the blood that flows through the kidneys, the tiny tubules that filter the blood and separate waste from it. Okay, and the end product of this process is actually urine. Okay, it contains water and the waste materials that filtered out from the blood. Okay, and also the urine contains waste materials such as urea, then ammonia and uric acid. Okay, the filtered urine, actually that contains the filtered urine that actually contains urea, ammonia and uric acid. Okay, the filtered urine that contains urea, ammonia and uric acid. Okay, after that, the urine that flows through two tube like long tubes, the urine, the separate urine that flows through long tube like structures, they are called the ureter. Okay, the urine flows through long tube like structures, they are called the ureter. And actually it collects in the, after that it collects in the urinary bladder. Okay, the blood, sorry, the urine that collects in the urinary bladder, actually it is a storage sac for the urine. The urinary bladder acts as a storage sac for the urine. Then ultimately the urine that is drained out of the body through urethra. Okay, ultimately the urine that drained out of the body through urethra. Isn't it? actually the urine that contains what are the products the waste that contains in contained in the urine. Actually it is urea, ammonia and uric acid. Okay, urea contains urea, ammonia and uric acid. After that, the urine that flows through long tubes, that is called ureter. Okay, after that, the urine that collects in the urinary bladder. Actually, this urinary bladder that acts as a storage sac for the urine. Ultimately, the urine is that is drained out of the body through urethra. Okay, actually that is about the structure of the human excretory system and the working of human excretory system. Okay, actually here we already learned excretion. What is meant by actually excretion? Actually excretion is the process by which the waste products from the blood are removed from the body. Okay, then what are the important parts of human excretory system? The kidneys, then ureters, then urinary bladder and urethra. Okay, and here the human being has two kidneys. Actually they are located in the abdominal cavity, and here each kidney that contains thousands of tubelike structures and they act as filters. Okay, and here through your arteries the blood that is brought into the kidneys. Okay, and the tiny tubules, that is tubelike structures present in the kidney, actually that filter the blood and separate waste from it. Okay, and the end product of this process is actually urine. Actually the urine contains water and waste materials filtered out from the blood. Okay, the urine contains wastes such as urea, ammonia and uric acid. Okay, then urine that flows through two long tubes, it is called the ureter. Then after that, the urine that is collected in the urinary bladder. From the urinary bladder, actually it is the urine that is drained out of the body through urethra. Okay, that is about the human excretory system. Next, sweat, a waste material. You know, the excess salt is another waste material that thing also has to remove from our body. Okay, and here some of the salt, excess salt that is removed from the body through sweat. Okay, some of the salt, some of the excess salt that is removed from the body through sweat. You know, when the actually when the weather is hot or humid, the body loses water through its skin. Okay, when the weather is hot or humid, the body loses water through its skin. Okay, then how does this happen? The evaporation of water from the surface cools the body. Okay, in this way, actually the excess salt that is removed from our body through the process of sweating or through sweat. Okay, the sum of the excess salt that is removed from the body through sweat. Okay, when the when the weather is hot or humid, the body loses water through its skin. Okay, the evaporation of water from the surface that cools the body. That is about the sweat, a waste material. Okay. Next, the transport of substances in plants. Okay, we have already learned how the transport of substances that takes place in the case of animals and human. Okay, that thing we already learned. Next, we are going to discuss how the transport of substances in plants takes place. Okay, and here the transport of substances in plants actually that takes place through vascular system. Okay, that takes place through vascular system. Actually, it is the transport system in plants. That is actually the vascular system. Okay, actually it consists of two types of tubes. They are called xylem and phloem. Okay, the vascular system consists of two types of tubes. They are called xylem and phloem. Okay, actually the vascular system that forms the transport system in plants And here, this vascular system consists of two types of tubes. They are called the xylem and the phloem. Okay, actually each of these tubes that organized into bundles called the vascular bundles. Okay, here each of these tubes that that forms a bundle, and these are called the vascular bundles. That is the tube of the group of such tubes. They are called actually vascular bundles, and that form a continuous network in the entire plant. Okay, actually this network that is spread in the entire plant. Isn't it? Here the transport system in plants, actually that is named as vascular system. And this vascular system that consists of two types of tubes, they are called the xylem and the phloem. Xylem and the phloem. And here each of these tubes are organized into bundles, and they are called the vascular bundles. And it forms a continuous network in the entire plant. Okay, you know, actually in leaves, the bundle appears as leaf veins. Okay, in leaves, actually these bundles appear as leaf veins. Okay, and you know, the minerals such as potassium, then phosphorus, then magnesium, calcium and iron. Such minerals, okay, potassium, phosphorus, then magnesium, calcium and iron. These minerals are actually required by plants to perform various functions. Okay, that is, in order to perform various functions, the plants requires these minerals, that is potassium, phosphorus, magnesium, calcium and iron. Okay, actually these minerals appear as salts in soil. These minerals appear as actually salts in the soil. Okay, these minerals appear as salts in the soil. Okay, the mineral salts are actually dissolved in water. The mineral salts are actually dissolved in water and they are absorbed by the root vein, root hairs along with the water. Okay, the mineral salts are actually dissolved in water and they are absorbed by the root hairs along with the water. Isn't it? That is, in order to perform the various functions, the plants require minerals such as potassium, phosphorus, magnesium, calcium and iron. Okay, actually these minerals occur in the form of salt in the soil. Actually these mineral salts are dissolved in water and they are absorbed by the root hairs along with the water. Isn't it? That is actually the transport of substances in plants. You know, through root hairs, the water is absorbed from the soil. Okay, and here the leaves that use water to make food, you know, for the process of photosynthesis, water is needed. Okay, so the leaves use some of the water to make food, and the remaining water is released from the leaves through the stomata as water vapor. You know, stomata, actually these are the stomata are the tiny pores present on the leaves. Stomata are the tiny pores that present in the leaves. Okay, and the water that is absorbed by the root hairs, and that water, some of that water is used by the leaves to prepare food, and the remaining water is actually the released from the leaves through stomata as water vapor. Actually this process is known as transpiration. Okay, this process is known as transpiration. That is the release of water as water vapor from the leaves through stomata. That process is called the transpiration. That process is called the transpiration. Okay, you know, the root hairs that absorb water from the soil. Some of the water that is used by the leaves to prepare food, and the remaining water that is released from the leaves through the stomata as water vapor. And this process is called the transpiration. Isn't it? Then what is mean by transpiration actually? The process of release of water as water vapor through stomata from the leaves. And that process is called the transpiration. Okay, what is mean by transpiration? The process of release of water as water vapor from the leaves through stomata. Okay, and this process is called what? Transpiration. Okay, that is about transpiration. The next, let's see how transpiration that makes water to rise in the xylem tubes. Okay, how the transpiration that makes water rise in the xylem tubes. Actually, you know what is transpiration? Actually, it is the evaporation of water from the leaves through stomata. Okay, it is the evaporation of water from the leaves through stomata. That process is actually called the transpiration. Actually, that process that makes the water to rise in the xylem tubes. Listen to it. Actually, about 90% of the water that absorbs by the roots that lost through the process of transpiration from the leaves. Okay, almost 90% of that water that rises through the roots. Okay, that is the 90% of water that absorbed by the roots is always lost through the process of water transpiration. Okay, and this evaporation of water from the leaves that generates a pull. Okay, the evaporation of actually from leaves, the water gets evaporated. Actually, this evaporation of water from the leaves that generates a pull. Okay, the evaporation of water from the leaves that generates a pull that sucks water and dissolved nutrients or sap. Okay, dissolved nutrients and sap. Okay, actually the transpiration of water from the leaves that causes from the leaves that generates a pull that sucks water and dissolved nutrients or sap right up to the tip even if the tree is very tall. Isn't it? The evaporation of or the transpiration process that generates a pull, and due to this it can suck water from the roots till the tip of the tree even if the tree is very large. Okay, actually apart from the water, it also contains dissolved nutrients or sap. Okay, the dissolved nutrients, actually it is called the sap. Okay, and the process of rising of this sap through the xylem tubes, that is called the ascent of sap. Okay, that is called what? Ascent of sap. Okay, the upward movement of sap through the xylem tubes. The upward movement of sap, this xylem tubes, that is called the ascent of sap. Okay, what is meant by ascent of sap? The upward movement of sap, that is called the ascent of sap. Okay, actually, in this way, the process transpiration that makes water to rise in the xylem tubes. Okay. The next, transportation of food. Transportation of food. You know, in plants, actually, the food is that prepared by the leaves with the help of the process photosynthesis. Okay, during photosynthesis, the leaves that make food. Actually, that food that is transported through all parts of the plants, that is stem, then branches, then flowers, then fruits and roots, that with the help of phloem cells. Okay, that is with the help of phloem cells, the food made by the leaves that is transported to all parts of the plants. Okay, and this process is called translocation. This process is called translocation. Okay, that is the process of transferring food from the leaves to all parts of the plant, that is to stem, then branches, then flowers, then fruits and roots, and this process is called the phloem. Okay, that is with the help of phloem tubes, the transportation of food in plants actually takes place with the help of phloem cells. Isn't it? Actually, the plants make food through the process of photosynthesis. Okay, actually it takes place on the leaves. Actually, the phloem cells that transport food made by leaves to branches, then stem, then fruits, then flowers and roots. That is to the all parts of the plants. And this process is called the translocation. Okay, what is meant by translocation? The process of transferring food made by the leaves to all parts of the plants. That is called the translocation. The process of transferring food from the leaves to all parts of the plant. That is called the translocation. Okay, that is about the transportation of food, isn't it? And today's class, we already learned about lymphatic system. You know, lymphatic system actually consists of lymph vessels and lymph nodes. Okay, and next came to excretory system in human. Okay, then you know what are the different parts of excretory system? Kidneys, then urinaries, then urinary bladder and urethra. These are the important parts of what? Human excretory system. Isn't it? Next we learn the transport of substances in plants. Actually, the transport system in plants, that is called the vascular system. The vascular system consists of phloem tubes and xylem tubes. You know the function of these two. Actually, the xylem tubes, they transfer water from the roots to all parts of plant. And the food made by the leaves, that is transported to the entire part of plant by what the phloem tubes or phloem cells. Okay, also we learned transpiration. What is mean by transpiration actually? The evaporation of water vapor from the leaves through the stomata. That process is called what? Transpiration. Okay, then also we have learned translocation. What is mean by translocation? Actually, it is the process of transferring of food made by leaves to all parts of the plants. That is actually called the translocation. Okay, children, that is the end of today's class. Also, we have finished the lesson. Study well. Thank you, children.